Almost ready to go, Penguins and the Anaheim Ducks in Southern California. Let's take a look at the goaltending matchup. Penguins starting goalie presented by Hyundai's Tristan Jarry. Saturday in Dallas, first time he's given up more than two goals in over a month. It's only happened twice in his last 16 outings. Ducks starting netminder presented by Kia is Anthony Stolarz. John Gibson is out due to COVID, so it's a 27-year-old from New Jersey. 6-3-1 with a 931 save percentage. Taco Bell take, Mike Sullivan on Evgeny Malkin's return. And on Gino, overall, he just said he's the type of player that has the ability to make an impact immediately, and I'm sure he will in this game. Dallas Eakins behind the bench for Anaheim, third season as the Ducks head coach. Seventh season in the Ducks organization. He's done a terrific job. Anaheim just 2 points out of first place in the Pacific Division. Well, as great as they've been lately, the Penguins just aren't the Penguins without numbers 87 and 71. After nearly 8 months, Evgeny Malkin is back in black and gold. Sticks are down, puck is down, underway from Anaheim as this road trip continues. Penguins looking to start a new winning streak after the loss on Saturday in Dallas 3-2. Toyota lines at the top of the screen. As per usual, it's the Crosby line that begins along with Jake Guentzel and Evan Rodriguez. Pittsburgh without Zach Aston-Reese and Danton Heinen. Due to COVID protocol, they are out. So Raheem Zahorna, Anthony Angelo are back with the Penguins. Angelo making his NHL season debut. Brian Dumoulin will bump it off the wall. Puck slides into Anaheim ice.
No flip for Malkin here.
As we told you in the open, playing with Jeff Carter on the left wing side. And Kasperi Kapanen, who has the puck here. And there is Gino as he skates into the zone. After the puck is Carter in behind the goal. And with it, Evgeny Malkin looking, shooting into the glove, or off the glove of Stolarz, and bounds over to the corner.
Keep it simple for Gino. Keep the shift short early on here. Get yourself into it.
Chance for Carter. He scores! Jeff Carter! Right out of the gate. Minute 5 seconds in. The Penguins up 1-0 in Anaheim.
Well, that didn't take long. I was wondering how Jeff Carter would fare on that left wing. Well, he's faring pretty well. Look at Pettersson. He pinches in. The element of surprise for the ex-Duck. Right on Terry. Turns the puck over. And in one motion, being a right-hand shot, he's able to spin around and rip that shot over the glove of Stolarz. And for Carter, he's on the board. But what a play there by Pettersson.
Jeff Carter with his 10th of the season. Tremendous start for Pittsburgh, which they have done with regularity, scoring first and dominating in the first period. They've outscored opponents 19-1 over the previous 11 games. Another first goal for the Pens, and it's Jeff Carter playing on that Malkin line, making it 1-0, and the Penguins trying to add to it here with Teddy Bluger. Races in, tries a shot, and it gets blocked by Hampus Lindholm, and the puck goes out of play.
Those first period numbers are nothing short of astonishing, really. Look at that play by Pettersson, using his reach, using the element of surprise. Terry had no idea that he would be pinching down that low, right at the dot area. I mean, that is amazing. And Terry had no time to make a play on that puck. I love that play there by Pettersson. And he's a guy that got burned by a pinch in the last game. He said, I didn't make the right read. That could, you know, maybe hinder a defenseman. Maybe he'd tend to step back a little bit instead of be that aggressive. I love it. Right on his toes, and the Penguins in the lead.
Marcus Pettersson with his fifth assist in the last 6 games. Well, Tang blasting, and it's absorbed by Anthony Stolarz right off that faceoff. As we told you earlier, Marcus Pettersson, of course, a former Anaheim Duck, second round pick 2014. So against his former team, he is on the score sheet with the assist on the Carter goal.
A simple shot there by Letang as the Penguins getting everybody involved here, this fourth line. And you see Angelo on the ice now with Boyle and Bjorkqvist.
Interesting line combinations. Of course, the roster's constant state of flux for every NHL team these days. It's got the news that Heinen and Aston-Reese were unable to go, so it's Raheem Zahorna and Anthony Angelo. Dress for the big club, Angelo's 28th National Hockey League game, his first this season. He's had some tough luck with injuries and COVID in Wilkes-Barre this season. Fired forward by Dumoulin. Off the skate of Benoit, trickles down low. Sam Steele will get over to the corner. Shattenkirk for Buddy Robinson. Pressure quickly by Crosby. Steals the puck and looking for a play. The captain in behind sets it up on the far side. The one-timer by Rodriguez couldn't get it through. Back to Marino with a shot. That gets blocked, and the puck sails out of play. Bob needs some Rivers Casino tips to win. What do you have for
him? We already got the Malkin effect. It's 1-0 Pittsburgh. He was on the ice. And the Penguins' fourth line, we just saw them. They didn't have a fourth line in the last game, and they're going to be very important on this road trip. And they got to defend the blue paint right around that area. Mike Sullivan not happy against the Stars. They allowed a couple of late goals, but Gino, so happy to see him back in uniform.
No question about it. Beginning his 16th season with the Penguins. Third in Pens history in points, fourth in goals. Injured originally back on March 16th at the surgery in June. Pettersson again, tries a slap pass, looking for the stick of Rodriguez. Bounces around Crosby, settles it down. Spins on Manson twice. Taps it back to the line. Here's Pettersson. Tries a shot that skips wide of Anthony Stolarz. Ice tilted here in the early going. All Penguins in the first 3 minutes. And Pittsburgh with a 1-0 lead on the goal from Jeff Carter. Spun off the wall and chopped out by Lundestrom. Ducks trying to advance it. Silverberg will get it deep. Tristan Jarry will look on as the Penguins get reorganized. Ends up the 3-2 loss on Saturday in Dallas at a 10-game winning streak come to an end. Their first loss since December 1st. 45 points. Anaheim also 45 points. Turning is Terry looking for Getzlaf. Alexa now in the corner trying to pass. He was double-teamed. And carrying the puck is Malkin. He'll tap it forward for Kapanen. Evgeny Malkin to the inside. Trying to get the shot off. Got bunched up with Kapanen and stolen away by Getzlaf. 3-on-2 for Anaheim. Getzlaf to Terry, looking, dragging, shooting. It's blocked by Dumoulin.
Well, Terry's got that shot like Rodriguez. He'll pull it in towards his body.
Kapanen tries the saucer pass, and that gets blocked. Good stick from Lindholm. Dumoulin is in deep. Indirectly to Letang. Trying to find the stick of Bluger. Flying in is Radim Zahorna. Kapanen from the angle.
Stick between the legs. That's a penalty.
And that's going to be on Ryan Getzlaf. Looks back. Doesn't like it. But Zahorna was tripped up, and the Penguins will have the game's first power play chance.
That's the old can opener right there. The 16-ounce can as Zahorna went down. Look at Terry trying to pull this puck in around the stick, but the body's there for Dumoulin. That's what he does so well. Stick defense, body defense, and there's Getzlaf down low on Zahorna. Zahorna, how about the hop he had in that shift? He was dancing on the puck because everybody else seemed to be standing still. He was moving.
Penguins to the power play earlier in the season was an area of concern. Not so much lately. Been getting better and better. Scored in 11 of the last 20 games. Up to 22nd in the NHL, and there is 71. Evgeny Malkin, second in team history in power play goals. Only Ovechkin and Stamkos with more power play tallies since 2005-2006. So you wonder, Bob, how the Penguins would configure this power play. Of course, still don't have Brian Rust. You know, he's going to factor in eventually, but it looks like Evan Rodriguez is going to remain on that top power play unit.
Yeah, you got the left and the right shots on either side, the off wings, and they're both going to let it go when they get the opportunity. You can see Crosby down there in front of the net. And Gensel, he'll be in that the bumper position somewhere in the middle, and he floats around all over the ice. So this is a pretty potent-looking power play, I must say, right now.
Penguins having to start up from their own zone. Anaheim very good on the PK, third best in the league, 85.8%. Pittsburgh crossed up as they enter. They are offside.
Well, that's one thing. A little bit different here. You put a different body on the ice that hasn't worked together for an extended period of time, so it's going to be different. And you have COVID issues. You got guys coming in and out because of injuries, and the Penguins have done a great job. And they have a couple of off days here along this road trip. They can work on this.
Pittsburgh got the 1-0 win against Anaheim back on December 11th. Had only one power play chance in that game. Got the goal at even strength from Brock McGinn. Casey DeSmith was great in that one. Players fight for the puck down low. And emerging now will be Crosby. Chips it back to the line for Letang. Evgeny Malkin drifting. Rodriguez right toward the net. That's stopped by Stolarz on the rebound. Crosby digging for it. Stolarz able to cover up. And a couple of extra shots there at the whistle.
Gensel looked like he took a stick there after that puck was frozen. He went down like he was shot. Let's see if he takes a whack here. Crosby's right in front of Stolarz. And he's going to shuffle it in there. And then there's Gensel. Take a look. You might see him take a little whack right in the back of the leg when this is all said and done. Yeah, right there in the back of the leg, Mirzy.
Not much padding there, is there?
That's the price you pay to go down to that area.
Crosby with the backhand feed. A lot of space. Rodriguez with the shot. And that gets blocked. Josh Manson there defending. Ducks will be able to clear a minute to go. And the penalty to Ducks captain Ryan Getzlaf. Pittsburgh regrouping. Carrying confidently through center is Malkin. Malkin over to Rodriguez. Drives it in all the way around. Gensel trying to stop it. Trickles back to Letang. Nifty maneuver. Pass down toward the corner from Malkin. Rodriguez a touch pass. Letang center point. Rodriguez, Malkin, Letang shooting. Off bodies in front of Stolarz. Stepping up is Hampus Lindholm and clears. Want to get it deeper than that. Good stop by Malkin. Penguins pull right back in with Gensel. Rodriguez trying to flag it down. Tapped along for Lundestrom. He couldn't clear. Now it's Letang on the hold. 13 seconds to go. Malkin below the goal line. Gensel to Letang. Tire Tempest, number one unit. Here's Crosby with the shot. That gets blocked by Lindholm. Driven off the wall. Another keep by Letang and over to Gensel. Gensel steps on in. Holding. Tries the shot off a stick. And it goes high and out of play. The entire two-minute power play for the number one unit. They were unable to score. And it stays at 1-0.
Well, I'll give the Penguins marks for keeping the puck in. But, wow. The Anaheim Ducks had three easy chances to clear the puck down the ice. And really, you should pay the price, the ultimate price, when you don't get it down the ice against a power play like this, and they almost did. Shake of the head there, but Jake Gensel and those guys were in the offensive zone the whole time. That was a two-minute power play. I wonder how Malkin's lungs are right now.
Almost had that chance there on the back door. You saw Gensel shaking his head at the bench. Pittsburgh with the game's first four shots. Lead up for five right at the front of the net. Just missing it was Carter swooping in Zahorna. Joined here by Kapanen.
Different looking line here right now after the power play.
Boy, Terry right in front of Tanzanciari makes his first stop, and it's a big one. Getzlaf. Drysdale flings it well wide of Tristan Jarry. The Penguins trapped in their own zone, but now it's some time for John Marino. He will survey and rips it up the far boards. And the Penguins again on the attack with Kapanen. So Horna heads to the front of the net. Kasperi Kapanen sets it up for Matheson. Matheson snaps it toward the goal. Sonny Milano will chip it forward, and it's skated out by Getzlaf.
Milano had that great chance in front of Tristan Jarry, who hadn't seen much action here, just watching his power play for the last 2.5 minutes.
Dominic Simone, lateral pass, nearly intercepted, but stolen back by Matheson. He'll connect with Boyle. Ryan Boyle along with Dominic Simone and Teddy Bluger at the moment. Boyle's outside the fray. Coming away with it is Simone. Slides it back to the top. Chad Ruido. The shot that's bought off. A juicy rebound there off the pads of Stolarz. Here's Matheson back over. Boyle's drive denied by Stolarz.
How about these giveaways by the Ducks? The Penguins with a little pressure, and they're just turning the puck over in their own zone. We've seen it time and time again here in the first 7.5 minutes of this period, whether they're killing a penalty or not. That's what pressure will do.
Anaheim's won two of their last three. They got points in 13 of their last 18. They played a lot of overtime, found ways to get points. And won in this building on Sunday, 4-3 in a shootout against the Detroit Red Wings. Buddy Robinson rambles in down the wall. Couldn't collect the puck. Pettersson got it free. And great breakout for Pittsburgh. Lead pass, though. Able to track it down, Rodriguez. Cam Fowler gets back. He played 35 minutes in that game against Detroit on Sunday. Buddy Robinson lays it in. Sam steals their fourth line center. Robinson uses his size and strength in the trenches. Steal, try to backhand pass, and that got blocked away, but the Penguins can't get it out. Right back over, whipping his steal. Crosby trying to force it out of there. It's carried forward by Gensel. Slide over to Rodriguez, end of the shift. And he'll send that into Stolarz. So the shot's on goal, 7-1. in favor of the Pens, but that one chance for the Ducks, Sonny Milano, a glorious one. Tristan Jarry came up with the save. We stay at 1-0 here on the goal from Jeff Carter at 1:05 of this first period. Trevor Zegras throws that one to the front. Off Letang, taken by Raquel. Shot stopped by Jarry. Malkin tried to get it out. He couldn't. Raquel dangles in. Pass over. Backhand try by Zegras. He's denied by Jarry.
Well, we've seen a number of turnovers by both clubs in bad areas of the ice, and the Ducks almost capitalized on that one.
It's 3 games in 4 days for the Anaheim Ducks. 45 points. They've been one of the best stories in the league, one of the surprise stories. The Penguins trying to start a new winning streak after a tough loss, but they just seem to run out of gas on Saturday in Dallas. Jamie Drysdale, first round pick last year. Many young talents for the Anaheim Ducks. Talked about two of them in the open, Troy Terry and Trevor Zegras. Benoit over to Drysdale. Was met by Radim Zahorna. Zahorna able to wedge it free. Puck back to the point from Matheson. Anaheim trying to break it out. It's chopped out the center end. Puck available. Pressured was Ruedel. Matheson looking to find it. He was turning. He collects and goes to Ruedel. We're past the halfway point, period number one.
Well, Penguins scored in the first period of the only meeting between these two clubs. 1-1-0 in that one. The Ducks have played 21 one-goal games this year, tops in the National Hockey League.
14 games in overtime. Most in the NHL, but as I said, they've just found ways to get some points here and there, and they are very much in the playoff discussion in the Western Conference. Ryan Getzlaf is their leader. Carries over the line here, trying to take that pass offside against the Ducks. There's the goal scorer, Jeff Carter, his 10th, Marcus Pettersson, the assistant, 1:05. And the Penguins off to a great start.
Just stay up late to watch the season debut of Evgeny Malkin. Here's another reason. Tonight's AT&T Sportsnet Ultimate Penguins fan giveaway gives you a chance to win a Brian Rust autographed Penguins jersey. Keep watching during the third period to hear the winning hashtag, then tweet us the winning hashtag for your chance to win. So get that coffee going. Stay up late. Bobby's already hitting the candy bars left and right. We'll be up late with you. More to come in the third.
As if you need more reasons to stay up.
Yeah.
Coffee, candy, and the Penguins up 1-0.
Awesome. And a great start. So good to see 71. He's back out there along with Kapanen and Carter. Jakob Silverberg from the neutral zone. Whacks the puck in. Tang trying to get some space. Derek Grant is in there along with Silverberg, who has the puck here. Chop that by Malkin. And now Brian Dumoulin. Pestered by Derek Grant, the former Penguin. Missed the last couple of games due to COVID, as did Ryan Getzlaf and Hampus Lindholm. So he's gotten healthy here. A few fresh bodies back for Dallas Eakins. It's Barry Kapanen. How good was he along with Malkin prior to the injury last season? Those two combined for 21 points in 8 games before Malkin suffered the knee injury against the Boston Bruins. They're trying to rekindle that magic here. On the line with Jeff Carter playing in left wing. Brian Boyle in behind the Ducks goal. He lost control. Kevin Shattenkirk will float it over to Rickard Rakell, trying to stretch it out, but it's off the wall. And all the way down to Tristan Jarry. Jarry with 3 saves so far. Kasper Bjorkqvist, 5th NHL game. Along with Brian Boyle and Anthony Angelo. Only 7 games in the American Hockey League, and a nagging ankle injury. Throws his weight around in the neutral zone, drops his man down to the ice. Kevin Shattenkirk will sky it through center. Got knocked down. Shuffled forward. Bjorkqvist gets it deep and goes to the bench. See the face-off advantage for the Penguins, having won 7 of 10. And a decisive shot on goal advantage. Routine stop there for Tristan Jarry. We step aside with 7:38 remaining in period number one. Penguins road trip continuing. A lot of Pens fans in attendance at Honda Center, and it's 1-0 for Black and Gold.
Dressed man right there in that colorful jacket with his back to us is Stanley Cup hero Max Talbot, who's in the game tonight, or at the game tonight, with the Sun Jackson, making the short drive up from San Diego, where he's an assistant coach with the Goals. Had a chance to get a look at the position or offered the position during the summer, took advantage of it, moved his family from Montreal. There's his son, Jackson. Made the drive up from San Diego and thrilled to see his former team, the Pittsburgh Penguins, in action tonight against the Anaheim Ducks. Very cool stuff.
Superstar sighting, superstar treatment, Max Talbot.
And he's looking fine, isn't he?
Oh, yeah. Maybe future NHL coach.
Yeah.
You see his coaching career getting underway. Very familiar with these young players, the Anaheim Ducks. Here's Jake Ensel looking, shooting, and a save made by Stolarz. Toppling over him was Crosby as he went to the net. Jake Ensel trying to extend his point scoring streak, which isn't really a streak, as we've said, but the last 17 games in which he's played, he's got at least 1 point.
Well, Sidney Crosby, he's put this into his game, and that's going to the net. And he did this against Dallas, and he really disrupted the goaltender in that hockey game. He did it when they challenged against St. Louis. He went to the net, and he's doing it again in this game. Sidney Crosby working along that blue paint area and been very successful in that area.
Anaheim wins this draw. Flipped high up in the air. There is Troy Terry, 22 goals. It's tied for third in the league. He's got seven of them in the last 9 games. Through the middle, shot attempt from Fowler was disrupted. Back to Fowler, tries the shot. Never got through to Tristan Jarry. Now it's Getzlaf. Getzlaf along with Terry. Right into the slot area. It'll be skated out by Gensel. Goes cross ice for Rodriguez. Rodriguez stepping up. Evan Rodriguez, 7 goals in the last 7 games. Ryan Getzlaf restarts for Anaheim. Still 1-0 score. Of course, the Penguins 18-2-0. And they score first, tied for the most wins in the National Hockey League, getting that first goal. Jarry was looking for an icing call. Penguins could be forced to break this one out. It'll be carried forward by Zahorna. The backhand pass. Able to flag it down, Teddy Bluger. Kevin Shattenkirk is back. The check from Bluger. Puck loose. Half forward. Not to right in front. Simone. A chance. Backhander stopped by Stolarz.
Boy, another turnover again. The Penguins forcing that one. The seventh. At least for the Ducks here in this first period. And they get it to Simone in front of the net. And Stolarz is able to square up on Dominic Simone. Matheson down low. Very active, the Penguins D. They don't mind going below those hash marks if they know it's a calculated play for them, if they have a third man high or if they know they can get that puck. Getting everyone involved here in this road trip.
Dominic Simone looking for his second goal of the season. Really good look there against the 6'6" netminder Anthony Stolarz. Pittsburgh controlling off this faceoff. Blasted off a shin pad. Lively carom all the way back to the line. The Penguins trying to continue with the forechecking here in the Malkin unit.
Yeah, you see the advantage of having Carter. He won the faceoff clean on that faceoff circle.
Pedersen steals that one all the way through. Marino to the net off an Anaheim player and stopped by Stolarz yet again.
Takes a little tap from Carter. Terry to Milano. Jarry, his best save of the period.
Period from Honda Center. Our social media post brought to you by Point Park University. As you would expect, a lot of reaction. A lot of Penguin fans thrilled that Evgeny Malkin is back, including our friend Brett Kiesel. Power forward, as we learned in the game of hockey at the RMU charity game. He's got some skills out there on the ice. Evgeny Malkin said he wants to play 3 or 4 more years. Said my knee is 200% stronger. He's out here right now. Another face-up win for the Pens. Twisted across by Kapanen, looking for Carter. Derek Grant overskates the puck. Finds some pressure as Malkin, but the Ducks will be able to clear the zone, and it's retrieved by Letang. Letang's been racking up the assists lately. 11 of them in the last 7 games. Fired forward, now steered in by Kapanen. Roaming out of the crease is Anthony Stolarz. Higher on the glass it goes. Kept alive by Dumoulin. Lateral pass picked off by Grant. Quick up for Silverberg. Couldn't stop it. It's an icing call against Anaheim. And we'll get a message from Shealy's Furniture, Appliances, and Mattresses.
Penguins Hockey is brought to you by Shealy's Furniture, Appliances, and Mattresses, the official furniture and mattress supplier of the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Got a quick look at Louis Domingue, who's backing up Tristan Jarry tonight with Casey DeSmith. in COVID protocol.
Got 140 NHL games on his resume. Calgary, second time backing up to the Pens. Matheson working to keep that puck alive and keep it away from Jakob Silverberg. Got it into the trapezoid. But it's chopped out, just barely out to center. Collected by Evan Rodriguez. He's not touching that first line with Gensel, Crosby, and Rodriguez. Here is Jake. Trying to work it across for Rodriguez. Rodriguez cancels out with Drysdale. Back up high, Matheson. Fakes, passes it over. Drew Weedle from the angle, right on goal. Stop, rebound. Crosby is robbed on the doorstep. It's loose, and did the puck go in? Looks like it's in the pads of Anthony Stolarz.
It is.
That close.
Wow. Crosby, unbelievable chance in front there. And Stolarz, I'm not sure if he knew where the puck was. The Penguins were trying to get him to move. They were trying to pretend like the puck was behind. You can see they came into it. Rodriguez put his hands up. Gensel was in there behind. There's Crosby. Just hit his stick. And a big save. Then his skate to his stick. Stolarz strong down there. And you can see the fishing of Jake Gensel. Tried to go in there with his fish hook and grab something.
And there was Crosby again. Top of the blue paint.
I know.
Here's Casper Bjorkqvist. Gonna get that puck to relax. He'll catch up to it now. Half board to the inside. Anthony Angelo snaps one. Off of Boyles. Posted up in front. Hard work from this line. Size and some grit. Anthony Angelo, Casper Bjorkqvist, Brian Boyle. Ducks will clear. Is this another icing call? It will not be far enough. Bjorkqvist helping out Marino. Pettersson reaching. Steele got it to the front. A chance again in the backhander tonight. DeLaurier is shut down by Tristan Jarry. A little extra whack, and now want to get a piece of Nick DeLaurier. It's a rugged fourth line for Anaheim. Not afraid to drop the gloves. Players like Buddy Robinson and Nick DeLaurier.
Yeah, Steele got in there and really pressured Marino going back for that puck. And that's the reason why there was no icing on the call. Marino had to get back there real quickly. And then he was knocked off stride. Take a look. He's knocked off stride. The big hit from DeLaurier. Puck's going to rotate back to the front of the net. And on the backhand, watch Jarry shoot out there. He pushes off that goal post with his right skate, and he just launches himself to the top of the blue paint to take the angle away from DeLaurier. Real good save there. Tough and rough, rumbly guys out here. Any of these guys could drop the gloves at any time.
Got Robinson at 6'6". DeLaurier always seems to be at the top of the list in the league in terms of penalty minutes. Got five majors this year. All that leads to an offensive zone faceoff. Tristan Jarry's made six stops and a couple of real good looks. There haven't been many for Anaheim, but some grade A chances. One for Milano, one for DeLaurier. Right in front, Tristan Jarry. A couple of huge saves in the first to keep this a 1-0 score. Back to the line for Letang. Dominic Simone sails one. We got through to Stolarz. Trevor Zegras trying to wind it up. Second leading rookie scorer in the National Hockey League. Trevor Zegras, number 46. From center ice, Teddy Beluger. Feathers the puck in. The check from Benoit. Benoit defending along with Kevin Shattenkirk. Maxime Comtois, number 44. He couldn't get it out. This is Letang walking the line. Spins it to open ice. Benoit shuffles it over to Shattenkirk. He'll relieve the pressure and launch it out the center. He'll skip into the Penguin zone. And another icing call. A lot of turnovers, a lot of icings by Anaheim. Coming up in the first intermission, presented by your neighborhood Ford store with Robin Dayton. Potash will have a conversation with the Dragon. Marcus Pettersson has an assist here tonight against his former team. As always, we'll have highlights and analysis with Robin J.
Another faceoff here. Expect Carter to take it this side of the ice. That's the advantage you have when you have Malkin and Carter on the ice together. Strong side here for Carter. That butt end away from the linesman. He loses that one.
Carter did play wing toward the end of his time in Los Angeles. Of course, the Cup years, he was basically their second-line center. They were so deep down the middle with Kopitar, Carter, and Stoll. Eventually went to the wing. Now, really, for the first time with the Penguins, but we're seeing him not just wing, but left wing.
Yeah, that's a whole different dynamic. It can help you in the offensive zone, and it did here in the first period. It can be a little more difficult if you're stuck in your own zone, and that's what you're going to have to watch there. Make sure you give him the help. Just make sure he uses that glass, gets it out, uses his big body to protect pucks and do that kind of work, because, you know, everything's a little bit backwards playing on the other side.
Grant got tossed out. Lundestrom lost the faceoff that time to Carter. Back from the boards. The shot by Ruweedle denied by sliding Anthony Stolarz. Allows us to take a look at the UPM Sports Medicine injury update. A lot of players on the COVID protocol list. The lone injury is Jason Zucker. Lower body injury, missed 5 games now, but he has been skating. That's some good news. And on the COVID list, Rust, McGinn, Smith, Aston Reese, Danton Heinen. But all these absences and constantly changing line combinations, nothing new for this Penguins team. Dealt with it since training camp. Isaac Lundestrom is going to shovel this puck in. Knocked off stride by Matheson. Josh Manson creeping in down the boards. Battling for the puck up against Malkin. Malkin tries a reverse hit there and drops Lundestrom to the ice. Ruedel all the way up by his chance for Kapanen. He's in and he's stopped by Stolarz. Setting it up, Matheson with the shot. Stopped again. Battling in front was Carter. The Ducks will get it out to center. Jakob Silverberg going to rev it up. Out-muscled by Kapanen.
Wow. What a play for the Penguins. Talk about a Hail Mary pass, and Kapanen gloved it down.
That quick strike ability. That's what Mike Sullivan was talking about yesterday. The chemistry with Malkin and Kapanen, they're game changers. Great off the rush. Here's Jake Guentzel. Kicks it up to his blade. Maintains his balance. Gets it all the way around to Letang. Letang with the pivot. Trying to protect it. Lost control to Getzlaf. Again, Anaheim cannot get the puck out. A lot of turnovers. Great pressure from Pittsburgh. 1:27 to go. The forecheck and pressure. Penguins continue to wreak havoc. Fired forward. Dumoulin. Second attempt. This time on the money for Crosby. Pursuing is Letang. And Hampus Lindholm will settle it down for the Ducks.
Wow, Stolarz, that's such a big save he makes on Kapanen there. The Penguins go up 2-0. This game, you know, is that much closer to their grasp. They don't give up many 2-0 leads, although they did in the last hockey game. But, boy, Stolarz has really been solid.
Had a really good year, Anthony Stolarz, the backup to John Gibson. And a good first period for him, 15 saves. Stop on Kapanen, a couple on Crosby. Try to drive toward the net here with Steele. Drew a penalty. Play continues on the delayed call. It's back to Shattenkirk. Sets it up for Steele. To the inside. Drew two Penguins toward him. Shattenkirk over Zegras. Fires. And it goes to the glass. Penguins can't touch it. Reaching forward is Boyle. Spinning is Benoit. All the way across Shattenkirk. And the puck came out across the line. Whistle sounds. Penguins will be shorthanded.
Well, of course, it was the San Diego, California kid right here with the Hail Mary. He flags it down. He tried to go over the pad and under the blocker, Kapanen, and after he settled that puck down, it just hit the top of the pad. It was a good-looking shot, a better save, and here's the penalty. Marino reaching in on Steele from behind. That line's been very good for Anaheim.
Anaheim fourth best in the league. Very good on both sides of the special team. One of two teams top five, both power play and penalty kill. Time winding down to the period. Tossed toward the net by Getzlaf. Contact between Milano and Jari.
Incidental contact, and there will be no penalty. But there was contact. Both Milano tried to body that puck, and Jari tried to get out there and make sure that he loves to attack the puck, Jari. He likes to get out there. That's exactly what he does. You see a lot of that from Jari. He's just such a different goalie in the last couple of years, especially this year. He's so aggressive here. He just doesn't sit back and play possum.
And he's been so consistent this year. No slow start, no slumps whatsoever. Jari first in the league in goals against average. Tied for third in save percentage. Carter pulled it back. Dumoulin fighting for it. 5 seconds to go in the period. Dumoulin shields it neatly, wasting some more time. Ruedel will do the same thing. And good work by the Penguins. One last flare at the horn is denied by Tristan Jarry. So, Bob, Penguins 16 shots on goal, 1-0 lead.
Yeah, a lot of Duck turnovers there in that first period of play, but a little of a power play to start the second. I like the game. I like very exciting hockey here. Yeah,
Jeff Carter with the goal, his 10th for Marcus Pettersson, 55 seconds into the game. Anthony Stolarz was good with 15, stopped Jarry as well. 1-0 score, first intermission is coming up next. I'm Ducks, and it's the Penguins with a 1-0 lead after 20 minutes of play, getting ready for the start of the second period. And in period number one, Bob, it was about quality, not so much quantity for Tristan Jarry. 7 stops, some really good ones.
Yeah, that was the best one there after the Penguins' power play. But he was challenged later in the period as the time went on, and he was up for that challenge each and every time. This one here, perhaps his best. DeLaurier got that opportunity out of the corner, and Tristan Jarry's just been so aggressive in that cage all season long, and just really a star in this league right now.
Number one in the league in goals against average, 2 goals against or fewer in 14 of his last 16 outings. And there are the numbers for Evgeny Malkin. 8 minutes and 13 seconds, 7 shifts, did have a shot on goal. And we'll take a look at the social media posts again, brought to you by Point Park University. This one from NHL Public Relations. Evgeny Malkin making his return to the lineup and beginning his 16th season with the Penguins franchise. He joins Lemieux, Crosby, and Letang. Players to play 16 seasons in Pittsburgh. Of course, the timeline, injured in March against the Boston Bruins, did return at the end of the regular season and also at the end of the playoff series against the Islanders, but had to have surgery June 4th, practicing since November 29th. He's done a lot of skating, Bob. We've seen him time and time again in the practices. It was clear the Penguins wanted to make sure that he was at 100%, if not better, just trying to make sure he's in the best of condition for this return. So far, so good for Gino in his first period back.
Probably right on track, I would imagine. And for Mike Sullivan, he's pretty excited to have the big horse back. You don't want to poke that Russian bear. You know what happens when you do that, Bears?
We've learned that lesson over the years with these last 16 seasons.
He's got the greatest character. And he loves being a Pittsburgh Penguin. And we love to have him. And we've been so fortunate all these years. 16 years, wow.
Brought so much passion since day one in the National Hockey League. Penguins beginning the second period on the PK with John Marino in the box for holding. Sonny Milano got stood up by Rue Wiedel, advanced the puck. And it's worked back to the point for Cam Fowler. Rips it over to Getzlaff, back in that same direction. Fowler looking and shooting, and it's off the stick of Carter. And the puck goes out of play.
Carter is so good. He's so big and powerful. You can use him on the power play. Now you're killing penalties with him. You know, you don't have McGinn, so Bluger is now matched with Carter. Not McGinn, who's not in the lineup, but he's such a great penalty killer. So, you know, he's so versatile, is Carter, and he might have taken that one off the skate a little bit there. He's going to check that edge. Tags in game. What's this, 1,001?
Yeah, after the milestone. Trevor Zegras is trying to twist it in front. He'll get the puck back. Shovels it along for Sonny Milano. Milano with the bank pass. Skated into by Cam Fowler. Fowler tried to get it back from Getzlaff. Fowler cut to the inside. Puck breezed right by him and all the way down to Stolarz. 45 seconds to go, and the Penguin disadvantage. First power play chance of the night for Anaheim. And winding up is Trevor Zegras, 20 years old. Ricard Raquel, he will pivot, 2-time 30-goal scorer. Hands it off for Fowler, all the way over to Milano, creeping, going back door, and Jarry, a spectacular save!
Amazing. You gotta be shaking your head right there if you're a Duck. That was just a bang-bang play. And Jarry had to travel quite a distance from right to left. Wow, what a save this is. Just in great position. He's got the glove on top of the pad. Milano across. Jarry denied.
Tristan Jarry, his best stop. Duck still on the power play. Troy Terry will wind it back for Drysdale. Feed to the inside, Getzlaff. It was broken up neatly by Teddy Bluger. And he will advance it, only 9 seconds ago. The Penguin disadvantage. Comtois looking in the direction of Terry. A little leak out the center behind Getzlaf. And another kill for the Penguins. Still number one in the league in penalty kill percentage. Only 8 power play goals against all year. Back to 5-on-5 hockey. Boy, Terry tries a shot. That's blocked by Dumoulin. Terry reaching for it. Back to the point for Fowler. His face was Rodriguez. He will spin. Hires it forward for Gensel. Couldn't enter the zone. Isaac Lundestrom now on the counterattack for Anaheim. Going to buy some time as his teammates are changing behind the play. Chad Ruedel. Defend off Derek Grant. Puck underneath Ruedel. Grant along with Silverberg. Hard work from Chad Ruedel. Now helped out by Gensel. And the grinding continues. Puck kicks free. Back it comes to Fowler with a drive. And that's knocked out in front. And Jari's able to find it. Another chance. Derek Grant was looking for some loose change. Tristan Jari slams the door once again.
Another big smile on the face of Jari. First, Raquel is denied, then Grant is denied. Took that one in his belly and then spun around. This one's deflected right into the belly here of Grant. He turns around and shuffles it towards the netminder. You gotta have fun if you're in there. You played some street hockey goal, didn't you?
No.
You gotta
worst,
have fun.
The worst position.
Oh, yeah.
No, couldn't pay me enough.
Couldn't pay enough?
This is going to be called here on the interference.
I guess they could call a penalty like this anytime, anywhere, any place.
Devin Anaheim's got a minor.
A rather mild announcement. Wes McCauley.
Wes wasn't sure of that one.
Known for his colorful announcements. It is his birthday, too, by the way.
Yeah, that's a penalty, though. And you know, give props to Kapanen. He didn't try to carry that puck. He put it in a spot where the defenseman has to turn and go play it. He's not supposed to play you. That's interference.
Silverberg from his knees. He's going to sweep this one all the way down to Tristan Jari. So it's power play chance number 2 for Pittsburgh. Interference, the call against Hampus Lindholm.
And it was. I thought it was a good call.
Yeah, you see it over and over again. It's pretty standard nowadays in the NHL. Another clear from Anaheim. Anaheim just 2 power play goals against in their last 6 games. Remember that first period power play chance. Number one unit was out there the entire 2 minutes for the Peds. But we're unable to capitalize against Anthony Stolarz. Rodriguez off the wall for Gensel. Slides it over to Letang. Evgeny Malkin, touch pass. Letang winds up. Passes to Malkin. Drive. He scores! Back with a bang, Evgeny Malkin! Power play goal. It's 2-0 Pittsburgh. He's back.
Wow. What a blast. And there's little Talbot. Take a look at this. Malkin starts on the left side. Goes back to the middle of the umbrella and rips it right by Sidney Crosby, who jumps out of the way. Malkin got all of that. Stolarz obviously couldn't see it. No. Great job by Crosby. Look, netminder has no idea. Crosby's timing's perfect. He comes across with the puck, jumps out of the way. He's got that 38-inch vertical jump to get out of the way of that puck, Mirzi. He needed every bit of it and had to tuck the knees underneath to allow that shot of Malkin to get by.
That last regular season goal that he scored against the Boston Bruins. And he was just on such a tear prior to that injury. Here comes Raquel again with a backhand try, and that's completely stopped by Jari. Evgeny Malkin had 12 points in the 8 games before he suffered the knee injury. He was showing us Geno beast mode back then. It's a great look here, this power play tally.
Get up, Sid, get up. Oh, that is awesome. Awesome stuff there. And Malkin got all of it. He's got the head up. And give him 154 career power play goals.
The second in team history. Evgeny Malkin with his first of the season. What a great feeling that must be all the time. The rehab, the skating. And here he comes again. Carries with authority. He'll take it wide. Spins it back over. Kapanen couldn't stop it. He'll get it back from Pettersson. Kasperi Kapanen looking for a pathway. Goes to the high slot, but it's intercepted by Milano, and he'll bank it out the center red.
Just to give you an idea how hard he shot it, it was 82.3 miles per hour on the shot. And it doesn't go in if you don't have the screen in front. And great positioning by the captain again, who's really making it a habit each and every game here of being right in front of the netminder.
So the scoring summary brought at Point Park University. And the Penguins threatening again. This pass cross ice and be tipped away by Getzlaf. Ducks couldn't get it out though, and it's Mike Matheson. Carries in by himself. Now has some reinforcements. A centering pass. Turning is Gensel. Ruedel over to Matheson. High slot. Crosby swivels. Matheson, look at the movement, the skating. Matheson in particular, all the way around. His pass, though, goes right through Rodriguez and comes out the center.
He can really skate, Matheson. You watch him just glide around the ice like that. It's so effortless.
Anthony Stolarz paddles this one around for Troy Terry. Top forward for Derek Grant. Grant gets lined up. He's trying to work it out of there with Rodriguez. Grant with a pass. That's going to be intercepted by Matheson. Lane's out there. Eric Grant, meantime, Penguins, this is his third stint with Anaheim.
I hope he kept his home.
Wouldn't you?
I can afford
this neighborhood. Cam Fowler sweeps it around. Good pressure from Boyle. Along with Anthony Angelo. Boyle walks out with a backhand try. Floats in front of Stolarz. Now activating his Letang. Rising shot off of Stolarz and bounces over to Robinson. He will lug the puck to center ice. Two against three. That straightened up. Got it deep. Loose back behind. Now Letang. Pushes it to the neutral zone. Simon Benoit, rookie defenseman number 86. Buddy Robinson. Couldn't carry over the line cleanly.
Going to be a nice. I know Kapanen didn't get a point on the goal, but he drew the penalty. And it was a smart play by Kapanen to force the hand of the Ducks, force the interference call, and the Penguins score on the power play. But it was the Penguins penalty kill, and Tristan Jarry made that big save on Raquel. Prevented the Ducks from tying it up at one.
Ryan Boyle tumbled down. He was trying to get a piece of that puck before the icing call. Went hard into the boards. He will slowly make his way over to the bench. Take a look here.
He went in kind of awkwardly, didn't he? Skate near his glove there as well, Mirzi, as he went down. I don't know if there was any contact there with the blade.
And Trevor Zegras on this draw. Carter wins another one. He was great in the first period. Penguins dominated in the faceoff circle in period number one. This puck is skipped all the way down and will be on goal, so won't be icing.
And Brian Boyle did go down. He's down the runway towards the room there after that collision.
Puck carrier's Letang. He will backhand in. Riding after a Dominic Simone. Also had a great scoring chance in the first period. Penguins had a bunch of them. This is Radim Zahorna. 10th NHL game. Marino, point to point. Pettersson.
Boyle's back.
All right, some good news there. Yep. Trevor Zegras looking for an opening. This will be twisted in by Rickard Rakell.
Well, we know his son's watching, so we want to give you all the updates we can.
Yeah,
that, for sure.
The whole family's watching.
Yeah.
Hampus Lindholm snaps a pass through the neutral zone. Ducks will try to dump and take, but a good stop by Tristan Jarry, preventing any type of a forecheck. And the Penguins will be able to break it out. Radim Zahorna has got 5 points in the 9 games he's played in the NHL. Zahorna toward the net, spin around past the Bluger. Bluger back to the line, shot stopped, rebound was fought off by Stolarz, and rescuing the rebound for Anaheim is Troy Terry.
Game slowed down a little bit here. That's okay. It's okay for the Penguins.
Good
not giving up much.
Troy Terry, here he comes. Terry, great in Pittsburgh a month ago. And that 1-0 score is one of the best players on the ice. He's been one of the best players in the league this year. And for 22 goals, tied with Austin Matthews for third. Josh Manson flips in. Jarry will watch. And center out, unable to track it down was Carter. Back to Cam Fowler. Tape to tape for Getzlaff. Good pass over the line. Sonny Milano trying to drive in. Shot attempt was disrupted by Matheson. Matheson again with the great wheels. And it's flying out the center. It was supported by Carter. It's back into Anaheim ice. Josh Manson, unrestricted free agent at the end of this season. Those are a bunch of the Ducks. Getzlaff, rich shot, stopped by Jari. Two Ducks go flying down. Puck comes back to Fowler. Fowler to his left. Getzlaff sets it up. One shot sails in. It's loose in front. A chance and they score. Silverberg. Jari looks back at the referee. But Jacob Silverberg finds that loose puck and makes it 2-1.
Yeah, that's that aggressiveness of Jari. He went out there. There was contact on top of that blue paint. That's why Jari looked back to the official, looking for maybe some interference. Let's take a look. There are the two Ducks going down like duck pins. And here the puck goes rotating around. There's a little bit of contact in front, not enough. Milano's way out there on top of the crease. And he's allowed that kind of positioning. There's not going to be any kind of call here. I don't believe by Mike Sullivan. It just not enough there. And the Ducks get a fortuitous rebound with traffic in front. And it's 2-1 right now.
Only the second goal of the season for Jacob Silverberg. First in 31 games. Both he and Rickard Rakell, a couple of veterans on this team, they have struggled. Here comes Lundestrom, looking for the tying goal on a wrist shot. It's denied by Tristan Jarry. On the rush, the Ducks threatening again. Trying to make it 2-2, but it's Jacob Silverberg. Making it 2-1. First, Evgeny Malkin, then Silverberg. One goal game in Anaheim in the second.
Back on tonight and gets a goal in his season debut. Speaking of sweaters, Gino's ugly holiday sweater that debuted on January 2nd will be available for purchase as well. As you can see, he signed it. It'll be part of the Penguins Legends auction on February 1st at legends.giftsmart.com. The site will go live on the 1st, I believe at noon. Proceeds will support the Pittsburgh Penguins Foundation. Gino.
Talk about limited edition. That is one of one.
That's right.
Place your bids. Off a turnover. Wrist shot is stopped by Jari. Derek Grant. That opportunity. You see a lot of turnovers on both sides. Jacob Silverberg getting an unassisted goal, his second at 8:33.
Yeah, you can see Gino say, let's go here, boys. Let's get her going. Jump into the lineup like Gino's doing here tonight. You want to be part of a winning team. No, there's a high stick.
That comes up into the face of Rodriguez, so that will be called. Penguins maintain possession here. Rodriguez will get up to his feet, try to retrieve his stick. As Jari goes to the bench, the Penguins get the extra attacker on. Rodriguez stays into the play. And turning back is Malkin. Delayed penalty. Saucered forward for Crosby. Back over for Malkin. Kicks it up to his blade. Touched by Anaheim, and the Penguins will have another power play chance. The question is, it two or four?
Well, he's spitting a little bit of blood, see? He's saying, look, I'm spitting some blood here. It's your tongue. I don't know what they're going to call. Let's see.
Number 21, Anaheim's got a two-minute minor for a high stick.
I thought they might just call it two. Yeah, he's saying there's blood, but, you know, he might have bit your tongue, too, between when you got high sticked and when the penalty was. But you can see that stick was basically down his throat. So Rodriguez is lucky that he's that it's just his tongue area there, Mirzi, and nothing more. And the Penguins certainly thought and maybe could have got a four there.
Rodriguez puts the mouth guard back in and will join this top power play unit, which already has a power play goal courtesy of Evgeny Malkin. Letang against him got the assist, by the way. So another assist for Letang. Give him 12 in the last 8 games. Another point for Jake Guentzel. It's points 18 straight for Guentzel. And the Penguins 1-for-2, saw 2 shots on goal. Doing it against one of the best penalty killing teams in the NHL. Third power play opportunity. It's Lundestrom. 2-minute minor for high sticking. Crosby weighing his options. Fires it over to Gino. Now Rodriguez. Winds that around. Malkin clamps down on the stick of Silverberg, and that led to a turnover. Here comes Letang. Letang, Malkin opens up. Passes down low. Crosby denied by Stolarz.
Oh boy, I thought he had that. Stolarz got over quicker than I thought. Sid had to elevate that if he expected to score. All tough, tough one.
Letang. Crosby takes a look. That Gensel goes there from the back door for Rodriguez. That doesn't work, and the Ducks will be able to clear.
Yeah, you gotta watch with Jari. He'll get this puck up quick so the Ducks can't change with that long change in this second period.
Letang sails it all the way across the rink. Stumbling is Malkin. Still advanced it though. Lindholm trying to win a battle. Four Penguins come flying in. It is Crosby. Low to high to Letang. Now Rodriguez works that left wing side. Here's Malkin. A blast, and it's off the shoulder of Stolarz.
That was a rocket
shot. The patented Malkin one-timer. Feathered in by Fowler. Ducks do have three shorthanded goals on the year. Two of them from Lundestrom. And he's in the box.
That was a good save there by Stolarz. Not just on Crosby, but on Malkin. So the two-headed monster with great opportunity in this power play.
Big handling over the line. Simone along with Sahorna is punched away by Stolarz. Paddle along the ice. Shattenkirk skips it forward. Buddy Robinson trying to get the motor going for Anaheim with 13 seconds to go in the Penguin power play chance. Gonna have to hurry here for one more opportunity, but Jeff Carter's doing just that. He is flying through center. Carter with the pass though and gets knocked down. Zahorna trying to spin it across. Dominic Simone down the middle. Going to Kapanen. Kapanen back in front. Loose and punched away again with that goaltender stick from Stolarz. Penguins unable to score. Ball to 1-for-3 on the power play. 5-on-5 hockey with Lundestrom out of the box. Here's Simone. Tape to tape for Carter. Carter walks on in. Around Shattenkirk. Circles the net. Carter opened the scoring tonight. Lost control to Shattenkirk. Just bump it back. 8:09 to go. Second period. 2-1 scores. The Penguins play game 3 of this season-long 6-game road trip. Got the third best road points percentage in the NHL. 10-4-3 record. From the corner, Bluger. Leads it back to the point. Matheson with the shot. And that's into a crowd. Recovered by Getzlaf. Around for Shattenkirk. Shipped out to open ice. And skating back for it will be Ruedel. San Diego native. Got it forward. Angelo. Heavy collision there with Getzlaf.
I don't think he saw Getzlaf. And he's a pretty solid player.
Nice play though to still recover the puck. And it's all the way in deep in the Anaheim zone. Fired out by the Ducks. Pursued by Milano, but Pettersson gets it over to his left. Here is Crosby from center circle. Shooting is the Penguins are making the line change. And now it's Simon Benoit for Anaheim. Here is Getzlaf, 17th year in the league. Ricard Raquel trying to dangle in. Met by Gensel. This is into the blue paint and will be covered up by Tristan Jarry.
Well, Penguins with a chance again to put that third one on the board. This one off the stick of Crosby. Stolarz was able to get across and make that save.
The two-headed monster is back. Both had some really good one-time opportunities.
There's Crosby down to one knee. Stolarz was able to get across. Made a beautiful save. It really technically sound in this game. And then Malkin with his one-timer. That was a rocket shot right in the shoulder area.
I bet he felt that one. Even as good as the gear is these days. Stolarz has been a good goaltender this season. 931 save percentage, 6-3-1 record, 27 years old. First New Jersey-born goalie in NHL history. Debuted in 2016 with the Flyers. He's been really good in the faceoff circle. Carter and Crosby especially.
Yeah, Malkin's only taken two faceoffs in this hockey game. Carter's there. He's taken most of them for that line.
Crosby had a swiped off his stick. Comtois looking for Anaheim. Same thing with Zegras. But it bounces to center and banged off the board by Manson. The Penguins have possession with Brian Dumoulin. Looks off ice and fires it forward. Crosby to the middle. Nothing happens there for the Penguins on the entry. Now Josh Manson picks that one in for Anaheim. After it, Evgeny Malkin down the wing, bumps it back. Jake Gensel, backhand feed. Chance here again. Dumoulin!
Boy, that hit. Looked like he may have had another one.
Yes. Stolarz was looking around, wasn't sure where the puck went.
Might have hit Gino onto the side of the net and went out the other side. I don't know how it didn't go in.
Kapanen will clear for Pittsburgh. Hustling back, Jamie Drysdale. Drysdale along with Hampus Lindholm. Lindholm, another one of those unrestricted free agents at the end of this year, and I'm nearly turning it over again. At 12 giveaways. Good speed from Terry to the net, over the head of Tristan Jarry.
He's got body position, he's got the speed, he's got a great shot. He knew where to put that puck, just missed the top shelf.
Evgeny Malkin dangles in, got a chance, tried the shot, goes wide of Stolarz. Benoit winds it around, it jumps the stick of Milano. And the Penguins are back on the attack. Kapanen, it's Marino with the pass, and redirect toward the goal. Malkin, he scores! He's got another one! What a return for Gino! 3-1 the score!
Wow, this guy's a monster. A human genome, isn't he? Look at this guy going to the front of the net. Stick down. Gets that kiss off the blocker and over the netminder. Stolarz has been so good against him. But there, the timing was impeccable with the shot from Marino. Just gets the stick down there at the right time. Away from the defender, off the blocker, finds the twine. Does he have any more magic? This is incredible stuff.
It is incredible, but if you're surprised, it's like, where have you been for the last 16 years? Evgeny Malkin, one of the greatest players of all time, the future Hall of Famer. Once again, the Ducks get something going on the rush. Steele with a centering pass. Puck will come out the center. Play's going to stop here with 5:02 to go in the second period, and Chad Ruedel is shaken up.
Everybody's getting clipped with sticks. Let's see if there's a penalty here. Maybe Malkin's got a chance at his third. With what 71's coming up with here in this game, but you know, you just never know when it's going to end. 16 years is a long time and a lot to come back from his injury. That's just a beautiful goal and a nice setup. Gino gets the stick down and gets the bounce. And something tells me he's not done yet.
One thing he did say last week, he went back to last time he had a knee surgery, which was 2011. The following season, he was the MVP of the league. It was his best year at 50 goals. Obviously, it was 10 years ago, different stage in his career, different stage in his life, but trying to pull from that experience. Back full force, a very serious injury, the knee surgery in June. He's been practicing since November 29th. There's the scoring. Malkin second of the game. Marino and Kapanen get the assists. Kapanen points now in three consecutive games. John Marino four in the last five.
Well, it is nice to be able to draw back from something like that, those previous experiences. But, you know, and I know as a hockey player, you just never know until you get back on the ice how you're going to feel, how long it's going to take. And you're hoping it doesn't take 7, 8, 9, 10 games for that first one to come. You can jump in, you can get that one behind into the net, that your team can win the hockey game. So, well on the way of accomplishing both those things here so far.
And it doesn't matter who it is. We talked about it with Crosby and his return. Took a while to get that A game going. Mike Sullivan acknowledged that earlier when talking about Evgeny Malkin, saying he probably won't have his very best for a little while. This is pretty good.
Not his very best is better than, than most.
Leads the Penguins in this game in shots on goal. He's got two red lights, and the Penguins have a 3-1 lead here in the second period in Anaheim. They track this puck down as Letang does so off the stick of Steele.
Yeah, this team is still dangerous, this Duck team. You know, they're only a shot or two away. They're not going to give up. As we mentioned, the amount of one-goal games they play, they're a well-coached hockey team. They play the right way. Yeah, they're not going anywhere.
Jakob Silverberg. And pressured by Dumoulin. Back to Lundestrom. Second attempt will feed it in around the boards. Leading forward is Jake Gensel. He's got an assist. Yet another point for Jake. Two goals for Evgeny Malkin in his first game since May 26th. Chad Ruedel is okay after a puck to the face. Not a penalty on that earlier play. Gensel recovers it. Throws it toward the front. Gets blocked. Ducks again. Trouble on the breakout. It's going to be Chad Ruedel. Filter that through Manson, but it sits for Gensel. Whacked in behind for Rodriguez. Blocked out. He's got a chance. He shoots. That one goes right to the top of the crease. Skating over Matheson. Jumps the stick of Marino. Gensel's battling for it. Two Ducks in behind the net. Trickles over to Marino. Rodriguez gets away from the referee.
Silverberg's just out there with no stick. Can't, he got a skate on a puck there.
Bounds over to Crosby. Silverberg trying to stay with Matheson. Gets a piece of him, but not enough. Mike Matheson, Rodriguez, goal line. Does a backhand feed, pinballs around. But it deflects right to Cam Fowler. And it'll go high up into the atmosphere, back into Pittsburgh ice. First player back, Crosby. Crosby, wing to wing. John Marino takes it in stride. Feathers the puck in behind. Stolarz looks on through netting. Cam Fowler to Trevor Zegras. Zegras lost control, pucking out. This is going to be on goal. Caught by Stolarz. Play's going to continue. We've got 2:11 to go in the second period. The story coming in of Evgeny Malkin, and remains the story with his two-goal performance. Raquel trying to pass. Comtois off the wall. Bouncing puck. Couldn't find it. Malkin does. A lead pass now for Kapanen. Kapanen stopping, dropping it off. Fanning was Pettersson. This is high off the side glass and will go down the distance. No icing. The puck dies shy of the goal line.
Good looking 3-on-2. A lot of speed. Malkin with the center drive. This didn't work out at the end.
Look at those giveaways. Both teams double digits. And now Pittsburgh guilty of icing. We got a message from Rivers Casino.
Treat yourself to a night out you'll never forget at Mataranos Prime at Rivers Casino Pittsburgh.
A big face off. Looks like I'm going to move it to the left side. Tristan Jarry, that's the choice of the Anaheim Ducks, what circle they want the face off in after the icing.
Huge face-off advantage for the Penguins. Carter and Crosby have been great. This one goes to Anaheim, and a long shot is stopped by Jarry. Good work there from behind the net. As there was a little bit of traffic in front, Tristan Jarry with another save.
And Getzlaf's pretty tough on that face-off circle. He uses his body, he can spin around, and he uses his feet. And he's able to beat Teddy Bluger on that faceoff. Change sticks here now.
And Getzlaf still getting it done. 17 years in Anaheim, 12 years the captain. That's a good mentor to have. We're talking about all these young guys, but someone to look up to, and a Stanley Cup champion, Ryan Getzlaf. And a one-year deal in the offseason to stay as an Anaheim Duck. Penguins controlling off this draw. Simon, nice play to shield it. Under heavy pressure and got it away from Troy Terry and over to Letang. Letang rips it in. Shattenkirk over to Fowler. Letang pinches. Goes past him and down toward Brian Dumoulin. Dumoulin looks up ice. Brings it forward. Taken off the wall by Radim Zahorna. Zahorna on the backhand. Gets it toward the front. Now it's Simone with a chance, and that's denied by Stolarz. Stolarz using that big frame, leaning to make the save. All the way across to Letang. Wrister knocked down by Bluger. Bluger gets away from Fowler. Head back to the point for Letang. Over to Radim Zahorna. Simone, centering pass. Goes out the other side. Kept alive by Letang, and the Penguins continue to tilt the ice here. Solid shift. Good work from Bluger. Zahorna. Dominic Simone. Zahorna, Simone. Letang, the touch pass. John Marino with a dozen seconds to go in the second period. Fire down the wall for Bluger. Bluger walks out, flicks toward the net, stop, rebound. Lively bounce off the stick of Simone. Bluger can feed the slot. And another weird carom over the stick of Letang. Letang just could not get that puck to settle down. But Evgeny Malkin, the story, Bob, a 3-1 score after 40.
It's been the Malkin show, and worth the price of admission for sure. Great to see Malkin back. He's got a deuce, and he's not done yet.
Malkin on the power play, and then at 14:38, 8-1 lead at Honda Center in Anaheim. We'll take a look back at what you missed. Missed a lot. Of course, the big storyline of Evgeny Malkin playing in his first game since May 26th. Wondered how he would look, and had an impact early on with his line scoring. Jeff Carter, 65 seconds into the game on a nice pinch from Marcus Pedersen. Evgeny Malkin, first of the season. The leap from Crosby in front. That one came on the power play in the second period. Tristan Jarry, spectacular save on Ricard Raquel. One of several grade A stops from Jarry in this one. Jakob Silfverberg got the Ducks on the board at 8:33. His first goal in 31 games. Made it 2-1. And then how about the look from Marino and the redirect from Evgeny Malkin for his second. Storybook stuff here in Anaheim with two goals for Malkin in his return. And the Penguins with a 3-1 lead after 40 minutes of action. They've been hockey's best duo over the last two decades, the two-headed monster, and they are back. And there's a look at some of the numbers from Evgeny Malkin and Sidney Crosby here tonight.
They played together 16 years now, Mirzi, and you can throw Chris Letang in with those two. And what a trio they have been, with three Stanley Cups, and wow. They're all going to go to the Hall of Fame. And that guy there, he wants one more Stanley Cup. He wants a fourth. That's what he's talked about. He wants to be that Russian to win that fourth. Well, let's see. He looks easy. You know, the amount of work it takes to come back from these injuries at that age, I can't imagine, to be honest with you. And the training and the work that he's done in the gym.
Yeah, the rehab, gym, on the ice, the skates by himself, and eventually graduating to the practices since November. At the end of November, he joined his teammates. Cleared for contact. We've been watching him skate for quite a while. The Penguins originally had said he was going to miss the first 2 months of the season. Now here we are getting into January. So overall, it's been almost 8 months since we've seen Evgeny Malkin in game action in the playoffs last year. Third all-time in points by Russian-born player. Closer to his idol, Sergei Fedorov. Climbing up the ranks there. Incredible return from Evgeny Malkin. And yeah, may not be done as the third period is underway from Honda Center in Anaheim. Penguins playing the California portion of this road trip. Next up, downtown Los Angeles and the LA Kings on Thursday. It'll be a 10:30 Eastern time start. Here comes Jakob Silfverberg. Ducks goal scorer. Drag it across. Thrown off a body. And now trying to retrieve it to the corners. Josh Manson spins it back to Silfverberg. Silfverberg diagonal feed, comes in front, and it's backhanded wide.
Grant has a lot of chance. Look at this rebound.
Lundstrom finds it, gets that one off the stick, and it dribbles into the crease. It'll be pounced on by Tristan Jarry. Solid opening shift for Anaheim in the third.
Well, Grant has had umpteen chances in this hockey game. The pucks kind of followed him around here tonight. There's another one. Got such a big frame, and then Silfverberg with this floating, knuckling shot right off the body as the Ducks get the puck just to the paraphernalia of Jarry, looking for that rebound. That's how they scored their own goal.
It hasn't really been the names that we were expecting, like Troy Terry and Trevor Zegras.
No.
More of Silfverberg. Raquel's had a bunch of chances. He's led Anaheim in shots on goal with three. And yeah, Derek Grant taking on his former team. Here comes Evgeny Malkin bursting out of the zone, going to Kapanen. Driving in, the wrist shot goes wide to Stolarz.
Yeah, that's that left-right dynamic where Malkin can make that forehand pass to Kapanen, who's just tearing down the wing there. He'd get behind defense. He can really stretch the defense, allow Malkin to do some of his work if he wants to hang on to the puck.
Had a lot of chemistry last season. Malkin and Kapanen combined 21 points in the 8 games prior to the knee injury. Malkin suffering against Boston.
Yeah, there's that puck support there. Malkin coming from behind the play. Look at that little aerial pass to get over the stick of Lindholm. That's just a beautiful look at it there, guys. What a pass that was by Malkin. And a little hooking penalty here by Carter behind the play. Giving the Ducks maybe their last gasp here to start this third period, get back into the hockey game.
8 power play goals in their last 8 games. They are led by Troy Terry. That's 6 power play goals. Penguins controlling off the draw. Carter for hooking. Now 1:25. Anaheim 0 for 1. One shot on goal and a previous chance all the way back in period number one. Zegras is the puck carrier.
That Swiss Army knife. Rodriguez is killing a penalty now. It's going to be offside on the Ducks at the far blue line.
Well, the Penguins' next home game is Thursday, January 20th against the Ottawa Senators. You can log on to PittsburghPenguins.com or scan the QR code on your screen to purchase your tickets for Penguins' home games this season.
We saw in the first penalty kill the Penguins had, Carter was out there with Bluger. He's in the penalty box now, so they used Rodriguez. Bjorkqvist is out here with Boyle, so using some different bodies with players out of the lineup.
Right down the middle, Zegras. Fire stopped by Jarry. Dumoulin steals it from Zegras. Drives that puck down. Carter in the box. Another minute, 28 seconds. Anaheim was dead last in the league in the power play last year, and a fourth best. What a turnaround. A lot of the same players. Getzlaff over to Zegras. Ryan Getzlaff shields the puck away from Boyle. Zegras taps it over to the point. It's Cam Fowler. Ryan Getzlaff. Fowler drifting across. Getzlaff in the direction of Zegras. Play catch at the top. Fowler and Zegras move to the goal line. Milano in front for Raquel and couldn't get a shot off. He gets decked into the end wall. And now the scramble behind Jarry. Chopped around to Zegras. Zegras plays it down low.
Getzlaff's got such a shot. He passes the puck so much, though, Mirzi.
Zegras tried the shot. That never got through. Milano supported by Getzlaff. He sweeps it around for Zegras. 33 to go. The Penguin disadvantage. Good pressure from Bjorkqvist. All the way over. Milano to the front. Off of Letang. Pops up in the air and gloved to the boards by Getzlaff. Took the check from Ruedel. Right to the hash marks. Bjorkqvist takes it away. Slams it down the distance.
Needed that clear. The Penguins get it at the right time, and looks like they're going to kill this penalty to Carter.
10 more seconds to go. Ducks with some fresh players on the ice. Max Comtois gets it behind the goal. Marino took a swipe at it. Comes to Rodriguez. He just knuckled that puck down. And the Penguins kill it off. 2-for-2 on the PK. As Teddy Bluger absorbs some contact. Got the puck to Simone. Simone looking at shooting. It gets blocked by Drysdale. Dominic Simone's had some looks. Four shots on goal tonight. Malkin also with four through two periods of play. This is Isaac Lundestrom. Hits the brakes, slips it around the wall. Comtois back into his own end. Pivot away from Gensel. Tristan Jarry leaves it on a tee behind the net. Marcus Pedersen, second round pick of the Anaheim Ducks. And over for Daniel Sprong. And a trade Penguins made. Malkin back to Matheson. Matheson looking, he's over. Pedersen called for it. The drive is deflected up and out of play.
Yeah, Malkin got a piece of that shot. Take a look at Zegras. Straight down the middle of the ice. A little trickery there on the power play against the Penguins penalty kill. And there's Getzlaff in front of the cage. That big body couldn't get a stick position in the right fashion. Certainly some talent here on this hockey team for the Ducks. And the Penguins have to stick to their rigid defense here. And they want to stay on their toes. They don't want to sit back here in a 3-1 game.
Isaac Lundestrom stretching it out for Jakob Silfverberg. Leaned on by Pedersen. Separates him from the puck. Pedersen. Jousting forward up against Silfverberg. Silfverberg feed it back to the line. Fowler, Silfverberg. Checked quickly by Pedersen. That spun into the ice. Now Matheson. Hooked by the teammate Silfverberg. Poke check by Rodriguez. Work back to the line. Fowler's shot. That's blocked. Crosby down to a knee. Penguins will get out of harm's way. Now resetting is Manson.
Yeah, that one's going to hurt a little bit. Crosby got that one on the instep, blocking that shot up at the point area. And he went off with a little gingerly there.
Winding up is Trevor Zegras. Could be a rookie of the year this season. Second in points right now. Lucas Raymond leads all rookies in the National Hockey League. Phenom for Detroit. Zegras. Hoping the puck will head in his direction. As this two-on-two scrum continues, third player in for Pittsburgh is Letang. Shovels that one out off the stick of Kapanen. Drysdale. Rifle it in. Anaheim gets to the neutral zone, tagging up to get back onside. The puck carrier is Malkin. Evgeny Malkin is going to chip this one in, wide of Stolarz. Jamie Drysdale, another young star for Anaheim Ducks. Second in rookie defenseman in scoring. The future really bright for the Ducks. Missed the playoffs the last 3 years. Got a lot of high draft picks and prospects. Many of whom are in the lineup now. Right now, second place in the Pacific Division. Matheson trips up Milano. And that's going to be called. Stolarz will go to the bench. Penguins will be shorthanded again. So extra attacker on for Anaheim. In the delay penalty.
Yeah, you got to be careful not to put it in your own net here. Here the Anaheim Ducks.
That happened recently.
Saw that.
Capitals. It does count if you pass it into that empty net. Penguins will be shorthanded. Here's a shot blocked by Crosby down to a knee. Yeah, in step. 3-1 score.
If blocking a shot up at the point. Here's a good look at it here. Maybe a little more towards the toe area there. The toe cap is pretty solid on those skates. The instep isn't. Kind of right at the edge of the toe cap and for the instep. And those skates, they don't much protection. They're built for speed, those things.
There is, yeah.
He skated during that last timeout. Seems to be okay. Back on the bench, ready to go.
Mike Matheson in the box. Penguins short in for the third time. PK 6-for-6 over the last three games. Teddy Blugerov, a steal shorthanded, drops the shoulder, gets a shot off, and it goes wide. Bluger looking for his second shorthanded goal of the season.
He was pretty close there, wasn't he?
Cam Fowler slides it back and winding up to Zegras. Connects with Getzlaf. Pass is barely held in. And the Ducks maintain possession with Rickard Rakell. Shuffles along for Fowler, over to Zegras. Zegras to Cam Fowler, drive off a stick, looking for the tip, was Getzlaf in the slot. Now hopped on by Zegras. Milano, Zegras. Feeds and gets it back. A step up Marino, diving effort Zegras. He couldn't come up with it. Penguins looking for a 2-on-1. They've got it boiled. Over to Dumoulin. Shorthanded. Dumoulin delays. Now fires, and a pad save made by Stolarz. Boyle tangled up with Zegras. The veteran against the rookie. Zegras pounded by Bjorkqvist. From the neutral zone, it's floated in past the swinging stick of Ruweedle. This is going to be whistled down. Now a message from DQE Communications.
DQE is a fiber optic internet and data access provider for businesses. Visit us at dqecom.com.
How about Brian Dumoulin lately?
Well, if you're wondering if he's scored a shorthanded goal in his career, he does have one. It was recent, if I can remember. Maybe even as recent as last year. But for Brian Dumoulin, no power play goals in his career.
How about that?
No power play goals in his career. One shorthanded goal.
I'd say it was against Edmonton, my guess.
Wow. When?
I believe
recently?
So. Yeah, didn't play the Oilers last season.
Okay.
Leave at home against the Oilers.
Okay. I'm not going against you.
There's Drysdale over to Troy Terry. Snaps that one toward the front. That was tipped wide by Comtois. Good work from Bjorkqvist, but it slithers away from him. Zegras got it toward the middle. Scooped up by Teddy Bluger. Racing up ice is Letang. Now he's going to drift back as Bluger gets it deep. He's got 18 seconds to go, and the penalty to Mike Matheson. Third power play chance for the Ducks. They're trying to claw their way back in, make this a one-goal game. Troy Terry picking up speed. Terry, the bust right in. Comtois reaching for it. Slapped around and past the blue line, all the way down it goes. Another kill for the Pens. 7-for-7 over the last three, and the stellar PK totals continue. Number one in the league. Touched inside the line. Pittsburgh offside.
Good to see Sid back on the ice after the shot block. Penguins up by a deuce and another great penalty kill. It's been so successful this year, winning them tons of games. Got to have great goaltending, but, you know, it's a system, it's a belief. It's getting pucks down, it's winning faceoffs. It's a lot of talk out there on the ice.
Actually, I'm amending my answer. I haven't looked up anything, I swear. Boston.
Boston?
Yeah.
Wow. It just came to you.
just something.
Well, they're probably both wrong. I got the iPad right here. I should just be looking it up.
Somebody's going to tell you.
Yeah, I'm waiting for it. I'll take 10 guesses. This is thrown in front by Lundestrom. The Penguins right there, defending in front of Tristan Jarry. Buddy Robinson, some separation against Jake Guentzel. Back to Manson. Manson, accurate pass for Lundestrom, hacked away. Approaching the halfway point, third period, 3-1. Evgeny Malkin, the star tonight. And he rewinds for Pittsburgh, looking for Carter. That got broken up. Nick DeLaurier steps away from Carter. And chips it forward for Silverberg. Silverberg, double teamed. Couldn't enter cleanly. Penguins drop it back.
You sure you want to change your answer?
Another one?
No.
Oh, was I right the first time?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
November 2nd, 2019, against the Oilers.
I should have just shut up.
Yep.
Shut up.
You overthought yourself.
Yeah. Thinking of another shorty.
There goes your chance at Jeopardy.
Hampus Lindholm gets it to center ice. Chad Ruedel, quick up for Kapanen. Kapanen trying to enter along with Carter. End of a shift here. We've been out over a minute. Stolar is going to drop it off for Jamie Drysdale. Now Maxime Comtois, second round pick. Trevor Zegras, crunched by Letang. Dumoulin crashing into the corner. Comtois, shoulder dropped into him by Simone. Back in front. And able to knock it down, Raquel.
The Ducks are still, you know, they have the foot on the gas here. The Penguins are defending hard, but the Penguins' first periods have been so powerful and overwhelming. They have really led to so many victories this year. It's just so dominating. I've never seen numbers like the numbers we've been speaking about in the first period.
We take a look at the Edgar Snyder and Associates hit of the game. This is a massive collision. Two big bodies, Anthony Angelo and Ryan Getzlaff early.
Some big bodies. Radim, Zahorna, and Angelo join the Penguins here for this one tonight.
I was hoping to see Zahorna, Boyle, and Angelo.
The biggest line in Penguin history.
Oh, can you imagine? Which way the Penguins would go at the bottom six. Get the word that Aston Reese and Dan Heinen were in little play on the COVID list. Spinorama by Zegras. Got some great hands. Trevor Zegras looking all the way across the one-timer. And Jarry shut him down again. Kevin Shattenkirk can't believe it. Tristan Jarry doing his usual thing.
Man, this Zegras is slick. Little spinorama, then a cross door pass. But Jari's there again.
Morning from Southern California, where the Penguins have a 3-1 lead. And are you ready for tonight's Ultimate Penguins fan giveaway and the chance to win a Brian Rust autographed jersey? Well, follow us on Twitter at ATT Sportsnet Pit and tweet us the hashtag Rusty17 and you'll be entered to win. Again, that's hashtag Rusty17 at ATT Sportsnet Pit on Twitter. Good luck and keep watching ATT Sportsnet for everything Penguins hockey. Where's my coffee?
A very pleasant good morning to everybody and a welcome to the Hall of Famers Night Owl Club. Be with you this whole road trip. Late night starts, Los Angeles, San Jose on Saturday, also a 10:30 start. And it'll wrap up in Vegas. It should be a great game against the Golden Knights. Drysdale shoots in. Zegras into the circle. Shot attempt from Comtois. Maxime Comtois, first game against the Penguins, second round draft choice. Puck's just going to slither out to center, retrieved by Drysdale, 19-year-old defenseman. Comtois will chop it in. Teddy Bluger is the first player back for the Pens. 7:45 to go, third period, 3-1 score. Malkin, two goals. Carter opened the scoring tonight back in the first period with his 10th.
I'm not sure the Penguins have played it as much in the offensive zone in this third period as they would have liked, but they're defending hard. They're using all their bodies. Their goaltender has been strong. Penalty killing has been huge here again tonight.
Every point so precious. Isn't it amazing, Bob? You can win 10 games in a row and still not be in the top three in this Metropolitan Division.
Still in a wild card.
4 points out of the top three, and now have games in hand. That's the good thing with the earlier postponements. When you look at the standings, you really have to go by points percentage, but still, it's amazing. You win 10 in a row, but the division is so difficult this year. Still have a lot of division games left. Have yet to see the Rangers, who've been red hot, although lost last night against the LA Kings. You have to see the Hurricanes as well. Troy Terry off a stick of Bluger. He will collect now at center for the Pens. Wibbles and goes all the way back to Chad Ruedel. Ruedel grew up an Anaheim Ducks fan. Mighty Ducks. Mike Matheson fires a pass to the far wing. He'll be steered in by Gensel. Crosby on the backhand. Winds it around for Rodriguez. Rodriguez takes a look. Slips it off the end wall. Crosby was tangled up with Manson. Coughed up right to Rodriguez. Rodriguez will wrist it around. Gensel let it go. Letang is in deep. Behind the net is Gensel. Evan Rodriguez slides it over to Letang. Sets it up. Dumoulin slap past Crosby. Scans the zone. Goes to Letang. Letang plays it back to the bottom of the circle. Cut off by Manson. Manson, the tight turn. And Silverberg with the exit. Penguins will drive it right back in, courtesy of Brian Dumoulin. Crosby falling down. Got it in the direction of Letang. Couldn't get a clean shot off. Isaac Lundestrom bumps it back as the Penguins are trying to make a line change. Under six to go in the third period.
2015 on this night, Mirzi, they retired number eight in this building for Timo Solani.
Finish flash.
And he's one of the best. One of the best. And a great person as well.
Jamie Drysdale. He'll fling it in deep, unable to stop it. Was Comtois. Off a skate. Bounces right to Kapanen. Hand it off to John Marino. Marino speeds into the attacking zone. Shoots it in softly. Stolarz. Made 27 saves. 10 bell stops in the first period, giving his team a chance. Once again, no John Gibson. He's on the COVID protocol list, the Pittsburgh native. Jamie Drysdale plays it to himself down the near wall, gets it behind Matheson, but Matheson will get back and send this puck around for Bluger. Bluger from Matheson. He has been flying all night. Gets stood up there by Getzlaff. Puck available. Shot by Bluger is denied. Now Simone. Fires it back to the top. Floated down to the corner. Teddy Bluger carries on his backhand. Flips up high. Ruedel. Simone looking for the deflection. Skipped away from Bluger. Pounced on by Zahorna. Over to Matheson. Matheson right through Zahorna. Over to Ruedel. Now the Penguins getting into the offensive zone. Some sustained pressure. More time off that clock.
I like this line tonight. They've had some good shifts throughout the hockey game.
Some of the best scoring chances for Dominic Simone in quite a while.
Yep.
Was absolutely robbed in the first period. Right on the doorstep on the backhand by Stolarz. It was one of those 10 bell saves I was referencing. Sidney Crosby's into enemy territory. Right there, Gensel on the backhand. That's denied by Stolarz. Jake Gensel looking for the put away. Gensel still applies some pressure. Now time and space for Shattenkirk. Long pass on a set play. It's taken off the end wall by Lundestrom. Lundestrom sets it up. Shot stopped by Jari. Some contact. He's able to squeeze it. He melts that down for the whistle of a faceoff of the Penguin zone with 3:50 to go in the third.
Jari gets out in front of that crease again to get that puck, but it's the Penguins in the offensive zone turning the tide. Gensel.
The Anaheim Ducks time for the number one Cochrane Expressway player of the game. Take a wild guess. Gino is back. Two goals, four shots. Beautiful redirect there. Good look for Marino. Evgeny Malkin. He has risen to the occasion time and time again throughout his illustrious career. Back to the performance in 2009, Conn Smythe Trophy winner. Have you ever seen anything as dominant as that version of Evgeny Malkin?
No, never. We got an empty net here right now. If we can get 71 on the ice, we got a shot, maybe. Maybe Tristan Jarry will send one down.
Okay.
Yeah. When he was the MVP, the Conn Smythe winner, he was so dominating of Evgeny Malkin, including a fight against Zetterberg, which
I loved and thought really turned the tide for the Penguins in that series.
Ducks get to the outside, but they maintain possession with Getzlaf. Off the stick, and now the puck available in the corner. Zegras for Terry, for Raquel, he missed it. Scampering free is Evan Rodriguez with the net empty. He has to gain the line, he does, and he floats it into Anaheim territory. It's retrieved by Fowler. Still plenty of time here, deficit two for the Ducks.
Gino's on the ice.
He's looking for the HT. Puck trickles in deep in the Penguin zone. Dumoulin defending along with Letang. Terry for Raquel. Chopped around. Kapanen looking for Malkin. Chips it forward. Malkin has to turn to the forehand. Goes to Carter. Carter with the net empty. He scores! Jeff Carter! Set up by Evgeny Malkin. That's the dagger tonight. Carter's got two. And it's 4-1 Pittsburgh.
Carter's looking at Malkin saying, what are you doing? You're supposed to be shooting it. But if you're going to give it to me, I'm going to take it. Great stuff from Malkin. Very unselfish. And Carter's able to wheel around and glide and create a lane for himself and puts it right in the middle of the cage. And the Penguins, they're going to get 2 points here tonight. And what a return for Evgeny Malkin. And pretty good having Carter on that left side, taking all those faceoffs as well. Very instrumental in that line's success.
Yeah, the two-goal game against the Seattle Kraken. Jeff Carter now 9 points in his last 9 games. And the Penguins on their way to points 46 and 47, getting closer to one of those top three spots in the competitive Metropolitan Division. Three-point return for Evgeny Malkin. Two goals for Jeff Carter. Kapanen will get a second point as well. Right in front. Nadim Zahorna trying to get a piece of that puck.
Yeah, he did. Stolarz made a good save there. And for Jeff Carter, he'll add a couple more to his goal total here as he makes his way to Los Angeles. He'll have 11 in 29 games. That's some power right there. I mean, look at that. You got Carter, you got Crosby, you got Malkin. You got Russ coming back. You got Gensel, who's the hottest man in hockey right now in terms of point streak, Mirzy. You have Letang on the blue line. Look at this guy, Matheson, the way he skated tonight. He's just been gliding on the ice. The Penguins are confident in all areas of their game right now, including their netminder, who might be one of the hottest, certainly is one of the hottest, if not the hottest in the league. And the Penguins, they believe they can win a Stanley Cup, and Brian Burke said as much this week.
Just the depth is incredible, and the standard that's expected, no matter who's in the lineup, starts with Mike Sullivan. And the identity of this team. Of course, great leadership with Crosby, Malkin, Letang, Dumoulin. Go down the list. Yeah, we've been singing the praises of guys like Dominic Simone tonight, and Nadim Zahorna. The effortless skating of Mike Matheson. Dominic Simone's been really good. Here's Marino with a shot. Down to 1:23 to go in the third period. Bluger, Zahorna, and Simone.
Yeah, those four shots for Simone ties the season high, and he's had a few that he's missed the target on as well. And this line has been in the offensive zone more than not.
PK 3 for 3. Casper Bjorkvist did a good job on the penalty kill tonight. And Tristan Jarry with 23 saves. Some difficult ones, too. Marcus Pettersson lobs it to the front. Never got through to Stolarz. You hear plenty of cheers because the Penguins are always well-supported in this building. To see in the picture, a lot of black and gold in the stands at Honda Center. Jarry's going to melt this one down. The whistle will sound. They're trying to start a new winning streak. Let's go Pens, the fans. Having a great time tonight in Southern California. I was talking about the standings earlier, so there you go, 45 points. Penguins will get closer to the Washington Capitals, but the big number there, games played. 34 games, 45 points for Pittsburgh. Carolina at the top right now, but you really have to look at the points percentage. Next up, the Los Angeles Kings. Kings have been hot lately, won 4 of 5, beat the Rangers last night at crypto.com arena.
Yeah, Mark Bergevin joining the the brass there.
And they signed him up, and Rob Blake to an extension as well.
Time winding down on this one. Ducks looking for one last chance. Steele's stick was lifted by Angelo. No question about the story tonight. The return of Evgeny Malkin. What a return it was. Gino Beast Mode was back in full force. Two goals, one assist. Fans love it in Anaheim. Sport of the Penguin jerseys. It's a 4-1 final score. The Penguins led by Evgeny Malkin. They've got 2 points tonight in Orange County.
There he is, the game's number one star. He was fantastic from the start of this hockey game to the end, where they had him out for the empty netter, where he set up his buddy. But Tristan Jarry made some big saves, as he had to. Marcus Pettersson, the former Duck, made a beautiful play on the opening goal for the Penguins that Carter was able to score on. It was a great team effort here tonight. And they're moving on.
That newly formed line, Carter, Malkin, Kapanen, 7 points combined. Two assists for Kapanen, two goals for Jeff Carter, and Evgeny Malkin, the star. And yeah, Tristan Jarry had to come up big as well. 4-1 final score.